did it. She did it too. And he's definitely done it more than once. What are we talking about? Plastic surgery, of course. And American stars aren't the only ones who like to give Mother Nature a helping hand.
The majority of the patients who do come to us, about 80% will be women. The rest will be men. They would ask us to improve the appearance of their eyes, or perhaps make their nose a bit sharper and higher, or perhaps pull off some of the wrinkles they have around the eyes and the face. The other proportion of patients actually come to us asking for a removal of a certain amount of fat from their bodies. This is usually in the abdomen.
But while the eyes may be the windows of your soul, Dr. Lim says the nose is really the thing you should be worried about.
Very often the nose is the sort of anchor from which you build your mental picture of what a person looks like. Exactly over here.
Get the nose right and all other parts of your face should fall into place.
Are the features proportionate to whatever standard that is?
It's actually proportionate for your particular features. So many faces, joy and pain in different places. Open your mind, set yourself free. Figure it out, what will it be?
Sympathize, understand, give love and peace to the other fellow man. The symmetrical face will be more harmonious. It may not be aesthetically beautiful, but it's more harmonious. I'm a model, you know what I mean,
and I do my little turn on the catwalk. So beauty isn't just about having the perfect face shape, or even the perfect eyes, or a well-placed nose. It's about how all these features come together and what you do with them. With the right makeup and the right lighting, you might not need plastic surgery to look like them.
We have the patients come to us in the hope that our surgery will actually solve some of the domestic as well as their problems in the jobs. These are patients whom we would turn away.
Image you lack, there's not much your plastic surgeon can do for you. And even when it comes to tampering with the hand of nature, there are limitations.
Like a person who is about 200 kilograms can come to my office asking us to remove about 150 kilograms.
But with liposuction, only about 1 kilo of fat can be siphoned out per operation to make sure there's no excessive loss of blood. At this rate, to suck out about 100 kilos would take more than just a few sessions.
We cannot make a person who is old look very young. You can make a person look very much like another person, but you cannot make the person look exactly like him. There will always be certain parts of the face which look different. If surgery is performed well, it's not often easily detected. But there are certain giveaway signs in that you can see scars over the upper or lower eyelids or around the ears.
And in case you're wondering where surgery can be performed in the first place, surgery isn't always about improving on nature. Sometimes it's also about restoring what nature gave.
Reconstructive microsurgery is another part, as well as burns, reattachment of the limbs from which have been severed, or if the patient has, for instance, a cancer over the limb and this is removed, we can harvest his own tissue from another part of the body and essentially reconstruct the part that has been removed.
With this type of surgery, the person's real tissues are used as much as possible. So there's no fear of becoming Singapore's very own RoboCop.